Él canta, ¿verdad? Yo digo esto y él canta. Sí. ¿Y cuál es la de los enfermos?
Good evening. Good evening. Anybody home today? Wow, it's all dark. Welcome, bienvenidos. We will start the Easter Vigil outside by blessing the fire and blessing the Easter candle. And then we will process in following the Easter candle to our beautiful church. So if you would like to join us, feel free. Otherwise, you can wait here for us. Vamos a empezar la vigilia pascual en la parte de afuera, bendiciendo el fuego y el cirio pascual. Si desea acompañarnos, está muy bienvenido. Muchas gracias.
Lumen Christi,
Deo gratia.
Lumen Christi,
Deo gratias.
Lumen Christi,
Deo gratias.
Let them exalt the hosts of heaven. Exalt, let angel ministers of God exalt. Let the trumpet of salvation sound aloud, our mighty King's triumph. Be glad, let earth be glad as glory floods her, ablaze with light from her eternal King. Let all corners of the earth be glad, knowing an end to gloom and darkness. Rejoice, let Mother Church also rejoice, arrayed with the lightning of his glory. Let this holy building shake with joy, filled with the mighty voices of the peoples. It is truly right and just, with ardent love of mind and heart, and with devoted service of our voice, to acclaim our God invisible, the Almighty Father, and Jesus Christ, our Lord, his Son, his only begotten, who for our sake paid Adam's debt to the eternal Father, and pouring out his own dear blood, wiped clean the record of our ancient sinfulness. These, then, are the feasts of Passover, in which is slain the Lamb, the one true Lamb, whose blood anoints the doorposts of believers. This is the night when once you led our forebears, Israel's children, from slavery in Egypt, and made them pass dry shod through the Red Sea. This is the night that with a pillar of fire banished the darkness of sin. This is the night that even now throughout the world sets Christian believers apart from worldly vices and from the gloom of sin, leading them to grace and joining them to his holy ones. This is the night when Christ broke the prison bars of death and rose victorious from the underworld. O wonder of your humble care for us, O love, O charity beyond all telling, to ransom a slave, you gave away your son. O truly necessary sin of Adam, destroyed completely by the death of Christ. O happy fault that earned so great, so glorious a Redeemer. The sanctifying power of this night dispels wickedness, washes faults away, restores innocence to the fallen, and joy to mourners. O truly blessed night, when things of heaven are wed to those of earth, and divine to the human. On this your night of grace, O Holy Father, accept this candle, a solemn offering, the work of bees and of your servants' hands, an evening sacrifice of praise, this gift from your most holy church. Therefore, O Lord, we pray you that this candle, hallowed to the honor of your name, may persevere undimmed to overcome the darkness of this night. Receive it as a pleasing fragrance, and let it mingle with the lights of heaven. May this flame be found still burning by the morning star, the one morning star who never sets, Christ your Son, who, coming back from death's domain, has shed his peaceful light on humanity and lives and reigns forever and ever.
My dear brothers and sisters, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us listen with quiet heart to the word of God. Let us meditate on how God, in times past, saved his people, and in these, the last days, he sent us his Son as our Redeemer. Hermanas y hermanos, habiendo iniciado solemnemente la vigilia pascual, escuchemos con recogimiento la palabra de Dios. Meditemos cómo, en la antigua alianza, Dios salvó a su pueblo y en la plenitud de los tiempos, envió al mundo a su Hijo para que nos redimiera. Let us pray that our God may complete this paschal work of salvation by the fullness and redemption. Oremos para que Dios, nuestro Padre, lleve a su plenitud la obra de la redención realizada por el misterio pascual. Amén. Nos sentamos para escuchar la palabra de Dios. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless wasteland, and darkness covered the abyss, while a mighty wind swept over the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw how good the light was. God then separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. Thus evening came, and morning followed, the first day. Then God said, "Let there be a dome in the middle of the waters to separate one body of water from the other." And so it happened. God made the dome, and it separated the water above the dome from the water below it. God called the dome the sky. Evening came, and morning followed, the second day. Then God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered into a single basin, so that the dry land may appear." And so it happened. The water under the sky was gathered into its basin, and the dry land appeared. God called the dry land the earth, and the basin of the water he called the sea. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth vegetation, every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit trees on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it." And so it happened. The earth brought forth every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed, the third day. Then God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate day from night." Let them mark the fixed times, the days, and the years, and serve as luminaries in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth. And so, it happened. God made the two great lights, the greater one to govern the day, and the lesser one to govern the night. And he made the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. God saw how good it was. Evening came and morning followed, the fourth day. Then God said, let the water teem with an abundance of living creatures, and on the earth let birds fly beneath the dome of the sky. And so it happened. God created the great sea monsters and all kinds of swimming creatures with which the water teems and all kinds of winged birds. God saw how good it was, and God blessed them, saying, be fertile, multiply, and fill the water of the seas, and let the birds multiply on the earth. Evening came, and morning followed, the fifth day. Then God said, let the earth bring forth all kinds of living creatures, cattle, creeping things, the wild animals, and all kinds. And so it happened. God made all kinds of wild animals, all kinds of cattle, and all kinds of creeping things in the earth. God saw how good it was. Then God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea and birds of the air and the cattle and all over the wild animals and all the creatures that crawl on the ground. God created men in his image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, saying, be fertile and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all the living things that move on the earth. God also said, see, I give you every seed-bearing plants all over the earth, and every tree that has seed-bearing fruit on it to be your food, and to all the animals of the land, all the birds of the air, and all the living creatures that crawl on the ground. I give all the green plants for food. And so it happened. God looked at everything he had made, and he found it very good. Evening came, and morning followed, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth and all their array were completed, since on the seventh day, God was finished with the work he had been doing. He rested on the seventh day from all the work he had done, he had undertaken. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. Let us unlit our candles.
Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Lord, send out the spirit on the air.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, you are great indeed. A manifold are your works, O Lord, the earth. Take away their breath, they die, and they return. to him will be my theme. I will be glad in the Lord.
Lord's endowed your spirit, reveal the face of the earth.
Lord's endowed your spirit,
reveal the face of the earth.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, who are wonderful in the ordering of all your works, may those you have redeemed understand that there exists nothing more marvelous than the world's creation in the beginning, except that at the end of the ages, Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
Reading from the book of Genesis. God put Abraham to the test. He called to him, "Abraham." "Here I am," he replied. Then God said, "Take your son Isaac, your only one, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah. There you shall offer him up as a holocaust on a height that I will point out to you." Early the next morning, Abraham saddled his donkey, took with him his son Isaac and two of his servants as well, and with the wood that he had cut for the holocaust, set out for the place of which God had told him. On the third day, Abraham got sight of the place from afar. Then he said to his servants, "Both of you stay here with the donkey while the boy and I go on over yonder. We will worship and then come back to you." Thereupon, Abraham took the wood for the holocaust and laid it on his son Isaac's shoulders, while he himself carried the fire and the knife. As the two walked on together, Isaac spoke to his father Abraham. "Father," Isaac said. "Yes, son," he replied. Isaac continued, "Here are the fire and the wood, but where is the sheep for the holocaust?" "Son," Abraham answered, "God himself will provide the sheep for the holocaust." Then the two continued going forward. When they came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood on it. Next, he tied up his son Isaac and put him on top of the wood on the altar. Then he reached out and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the Lord's messenger called to him from heaven, "Abraham, Abraham." "Here I am," he answered. "Do not lay your hand on the boy," said the messenger. "Do not do the least thing to him. I know now how devoted you are to God, since you did not withhold from me your own beloved son. As Abraham looked about, he spied a ram caught by its horns in the thicket. So he went and took the ram and offered it up as a holocaust in place of his son. Abraham named the site Yahweh Yireh. Hence, people now say, on the mountain, the Lord will see. Again, the Lord's messenger called to Abraham from heaven and said, I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you acted as you did, and not withholding from me your beloved son, I will bless you abundantly and make your descendants as countless as the stars of the sky and the sands of the seashore. Your descendants shall take possession of the gates of their enemies. And in your descendants, all the nations of the earth shall find blessing. All this because you obeyed my command. The word of the Lord.
Protégeme, Dios mío, protégeme, Dios mío, que me refugio en ti, me refugio en ti. Protégeme, Dios mío, protégeme, Dios mío, que me El Señor es el lote de mi heredad y mi copa. Mi suerte está en tu mano. Tengo siempre presente al Señor. Con él a mi derecha no vacilaré. Protégeme, Dios mío, protégeme. Que me refugio en ti, me refugio en ti. Por eso se me alegra el corazón, se gozan mis entrañas, y mi carne descansa serena, porque no me entregarás a la muerte, ni dejarás a tu fiel conocer la corrupción. Protégeme, Dios mío, protégeme, Dios mío, que me refugio en ti, me refugio en ti. Me enseñarás el sendero de la vida, me saciarás de gozo en tu presencia, de alegría perpetua a tu derecha, de alegría perpetua a tu derecha. Protégeme, Dios mío, protégeme, que me refugio en ti, me refugio en ti.
Let us pray. Oremos. O God, Supreme Father of the faithful, who increase the children of your promise by pouring out the grace of adoption throughout the whole world, and who through the Paschal mystery make your servant Abraham father of nations, as once you swore, grant, we pray, that your peoples may enter worthily into the grace to which you call them, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Lectura del libro de Éxodo. En aquellos días, dijo el Señor a Moisés, ¿por qué sigues clamando a mí? Diles a los israelitas que se pongan en marcha, y tú, alza tu bastón, extiende tu mano sobre el mar y divídelo, para que los israelitas entren en el mar sin mojarse. Yo voy a endurecer el corazón de los egipcios para que los persigan, y me cubriré de gloria a expensas del faraón y de todo su ejército, de sus carros y jinetes. Cuando me haya cubierto de gloria a expensas del faraón, de sus carros y jinetes, los egipcios sabrán que yo soy el Señor. El ángel del Señor, que iba al frente de los huestes de Israel, se colocó tras ellas. Y la columna de nubes que iba adelante también se desplazó y se puso a sus espaldas, entre el campamento de los israelitas y el campamento de los egipcios. La nube era tinieblas para unos y claridad para otros. Y así los ejércitos no trabaron contacto durante toda la noche. Moisés extendió la mano sobre el mar, y el Señor hizo soplar durante toda la noche un fuerte viento del este, que secó el mar y dividió las aguas. Los israelitas entraron en el mar y no se mojaban, mientras las aguas formaban una muralla a su derecha y a su izquierda. Los egipcios se lanzaron en su persecución, y toda la caballería del faraón, sus carros y jinetes, entraron tras ellos en el mar. Hacia el amanecer, el Señor miró desde las columnas de fuego y humo al ejército de los egipcios y sembró entre ellos el pánico. Trabó las ruedas de sus carros, de suerte que no avanzaban sino pesadamente. Dijeron entonces los egipcios, «Huyamos de Israel, porque el Señor lucha en su favor contra Egipto». Entonces el Señor le dijo a Moisés, «Extiende tu mano sobre el mar, para que vuelvan las aguas sobre los egipcios, sus carros y sus jinetes». Y extendió Moisés su mano sobre el mar, y al amanecer las aguas volvieron a su sitio. De suerte que al huir, los egipcios se encontraban con ellas, y el Señor los derribó en medio del mar. Volvieron las aguas y cubrieron los carros, a los jinetes y a todo el ejército del faraón que se había metido en el mar para perseguir a Israel. Ni uno solo se salvó. Pero los hijos de Israel caminaban por lo seco en medio del mar. Las aguas les hacían muralla a la derecha e izquierda. Aquel día salvó el Señor a Israel de las manos de Egipto. Israel vio a los egipcios muertos en la orilla del mar. Israel vio la mano fuerte del Señor sobre los egipcios, Y el pueblo temió al Señor y creyó en el Señor y en Moisés, su siervo. Entonces Moisés y los hijos de Israel cantaron este cántico al Señor.
I will sing to the God who sets me free. Pharaoh's army and his chariots God cast into the sea. The Lord is my strength, my protection, and my shield. Pharaoh's army and his chariots God cast into the sea. Our God is a warrior whose name is the Lord, God of might, God of victory. I will sing to the God who sets me free. Pharaoh's army and his chariots God cast into the sea. The brave and the mighty, the pride of Pharaoh's army, God plunged them to the bottom of the sea like a stone. The hand of the Lord is magnificent in power. The Lord has crushed our foes. I will sing to the God who sets me free. Pharaoh's army and his chariots God cast into the sea. O God, who redeems, who delivers us from slavery, you set us on the mountain of your holy place. Your throne and your temple shall endure for all time. Your reign shall never end. I will sing to the God who sets me free. Pharaoh's army and his chariots God cast into the sea. Pharaoh's army and his chariots God cast into the sea.
Oremos, let us pray. Señor Dios, cuyos antiguos prodigios los percibimos resplandeciendo también en nuestros tiempos, puesto que aquello mismo que realizó la diestra de tu poder para liberar a un solo pueblo de la esclavitud del faraón, lo sigue realizando también ahora, por medio del agua del bautismo, para salvar a todas las naciones, concede que todos los hombres del mundo lleguen a contarse entre los hijos de Abraham y participen de la dignidad del pueblo elegido, por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amén.
Please be seated.
Lectura del profeta Isaías. El que te creó te tomará por esposa. Su nombre es Señor de los ejércitos. Tu redentor es el Santo de Israel. Será llamado Dios de toda la tierra. Como una mujer abandonada y abatida, te vuelve a llamar el Señor. ¿Acaso repudia uno a la esposa de la juventud? Dice tu Dios. Por un instante te abandoné, pero con inmensa misericordia te volveré a tomar. En un arrebato de ira, te oculté un instante mi rostro, pero con amor eterno me he apiadado de ti, dice el Señor, tu Redentor. Me pasa ahora como en los días de Noé. Entonces juré que las aguas del diluvio no volverían a cubrir la tierra. Ahora juro no enojarme ya contra ti, ni volveré a amenazarte. Podrán desaparecer los montes y hundirse las colinas, pero mi amor por ti no desaparecerá. Mi alianza de paz quedará firme para siempre. Lo dice el Señor, el que se apiada de ti. Tú, la afligida, la zarandeada por la tempestad, la no consolada. He aquí que yo mismo coloco tus piedras sobre piedras finas, tus cimientos sobre zafiros. Te pondré alemas de rubí y puertas de esmeralda y murallas de piedras preciosas. Todos tus hijos serán discípulos del Señor y será grande su prosperidad. Serás consolidada en la justicia. Destierra la angustia, pues ya nada tienes que temer. Olvida tu miedo, porque ya no se acercará a ti. Palabra de Dios.
Ten salsaré, Señor, porque tú me has librado. I will praise you, O Lord, for you have rescued me. Ten salsaré, Señor, porque tú me has librado. I will praise you, O Lord, for you have rescued me. Te ensalzaré, Señor, porque me has librado y no has dejado que más enemigas se rían de mí. Sacaste mi vida del abismo y me hiciste revivir cuando bajaba a la fosa. Te ensalzaré, Señor, porque tú me has librado. I will praise you, O Lord, for you have rescued me. Sing praise to the Lord, you faithful ones. Give thanks to God's holy name. A moment is God's anger, a lifetime is God's love. So tears may come at nightfall, but joy comes with the dawn. Te ensalzaré, Señor, porque tú me has librado. I will praise you, O Lord, for you have rescued me. Escucha, Señor, y ten piedad de mí. Señor, socórrame. Cambiaste mi luto en danzas. Señor, Dios mío, te daré gracias por siempre. Te ensalzaré, Señor, porque tú me has librado. I will praise you, O Lord, for you have
Oremos. Let us pray. Dios Todopoderoso y Eterno, multiplica en honor a tu nombre cuanto prometiste a nuestros padres en la fe, y acrecienta la descendencia por ti prometida mediante la santa adopción filial, para que aquello que los antiguos patriarcas no dudaron que habría de acontecer, tu Iglesia advierta que ya está en gran parte cumplido por Jesucristo nuestro Señor. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, all you who are thirsty, come to the water. You who have no money, come, receive grain and eat. Come without paying and without cost. Drink wine and milk. Why spend your money for what is not bread, your wages for what fails to satisfy? Heed me, and you shall eat well. You shall delight in rich fare. Come to me heedfully. Listen, that you may have life. I will renew you with everlasting covenant, the benefits assured to David. As I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander of nations, so shall you summon a nation you knew not. A nation that knew you not shall run to you because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, who has glorified you. Seek the Lord while you may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way and the wicked man his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, for our God, who is generous in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. For just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down and do not return there, till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I send it. The word of the Lord.
With joy you shall draw water from the springs of endless life. With joy you shall draw water from the living well of God. With joy you shall draw water from the springs of endless life. With joy you shall draw water from the living well of God. God indeed is my Savior. I will never be afraid. my strength and courage is the Lord. My Savior is my song. With joy you shall draw water from the springs of endless life. With joy you shall draw water from the living well of God. Give thanks and praise the name of God. Sing out to all the earth the wondrous deeds that God has done, our Savior and our song. With joy you shall draw water from the springs of endless life. With joy you shall draw water from the living well of God. Shout with joy, O Zion, for dwelling in your midst is the Holy One of Israel, your Savior and your song. With joy you shall draw water from the springs of endless life. With joy you shall draw water from the living well of God.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, sole hope of the world, who by the preaching of your prophet unveiled the mysteries of this present age, graciously increase the longing of your people, for only at the prompting of your grace do the faithful progress in any kind of virtue, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Baruch. Hear, O Israel, the commandments of life. Listen and know prudence. How is it, Israel, that you are in the land of your foes, grown old in a foreign land, defiled with the dead, accounted with those destined for the netherworld? You have forsaken the fountain of wisdom. Had you walked in the way of God, you would have dwelt in enduring peace. Learn where prudence is, where strength, where understanding, that you may know also where are length of days and life, where light of the eyes and peace. Who has found the place of wisdom? Who has entered into her treasuries? The one who knows all things knows her. He has probed her by his knowledge. The one who established the earth for all time and filled it with four-headed, four-footed beasts. He who dismisses the light and it departs, calls it and it obeys him trembling. Before whom the stars at their posts shine and rejoice. When he calls them, They answer, "Here we are, shining with joy for their Maker. Such is our God. No other is to be compared to Him. He has traced out the whole way of understanding and has given her to Jacob, His servant, to Israel, His beloved son. Since then, she has appeared on earth and moved among people. She is the book of the precepts of God, the law that endures forever. All who cling to her will live, but those will die who forsake her. Turn, O Jacob, and receive her. Walk by her light toward splendor. Give not your glory to another, your privileges to an alien race. Blessed are we, O Israel, for what pleases God is known to us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Del Señor instruyen al ignorante. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. Tú tienes, Señor, palabras de vida eterna. The precepts of the Lord are right, they gladden the heart. The command of the Lord is clear, it gives light to the eyes. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. To Tienes, Señor, palabras de vida eterna. La voluntad de Dios es santa y para siempre estable. Los mandatos del Señor son verdaderos y enteramente justos. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. Tú tienes, Señor, palabras de vida eterna.
Let us pray. O God, who constantly increase your church
by your call to the nations, graciously grant to those you wash clean in the waters of baptism the assurance of your unfailing protection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, when the house of Israel lived in their land, they defiled it by their conduct and their deeds. Therefore, I poured out my fury upon them. Because of the blood that they poured out on the ground, and because they defiled it with idols. I scattered them among the nations, dispersing them over foreign lands, according to their conduct and deeds I judged them. But when they came among the nations, wherever they came, they served to profane my holy name. Because it was said of them, these are the people of the Lord, yet they had to leave their land. So I have relented because of my holy name, which the house of Israel profaned among the nations where they came. Therefore, say to the house of Israel, thus says the Lord God, not for your sakes do I act, house of Israel, but for the sake of my holy name, which you profaned among the nations to which you came. I will prove the holiness of my great name, profaned among the nations in whose midst you had profaned it. Thus, the nations shall know that I am the Lord, says the Lord God, when in their sight I prove my holiness through you. For I will take you away from among the nations, gather you from all the foreign lands, and bring you back to your own land. I will sprinkle clean water upon you to cleanse you from all your impurities, and from all your idols I will cleanse you. I will give you a new heart and place in you a new spirit, taking from your bodies your stony hearts and giving you natural hearts. I will put my spirit within you and make you live by my statutes, careful to observe my decrees. You shall live in the land I gave your fathers. You shall be my people, and I will be your God. The word of the Lord.
Deer that longs for running streams, my soul.
Let us pray. O God of unchanging power and eternal light, look with favor on the wondrous mystery of the whole church and serenely accomplish the work of human salvation, which you plan from all eternity. May the whole world know and see that what was cast down is raised up, what had become old is made new, and all things are restored to integrity through Christ, just as by him they came into being, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God.
Let us pray. Oremos. O God, who make this most sacred night radiant with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your church a spirit of adoption, so that renewed in body and mind, we may render you undivided service. Dios nuestro, que hace resplandecer esta noche con la gloria de la resurrección del Señor, aviva en tu iglesia el espíritu de adopción filial, para que renovados en cuerpo y alma, nos entreguemos fielmente a tu servicio. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Lectura de la carta de San Pablo a los Romanos. Hermanos, todos los que hemos sido incorporados a Cristo Jesús por medio del bautismo, hemos sido incorporados a Él en su muerte. En efecto, por el bautismo fuimos sepultados con Él en su muerte, para que así como Cristo resucitó de entre los muertos por la gloria del Padre, así también nosotros llevemos una vida nueva. Porque si hemos estado íntimamente unidos a Él por una muerte semejante a la suya, también lo estaremos en su resurrección. Sabemos que nuestro hombre viejo fue crucificado con Cristo, para que el cuerpo del pecado quedara destruido, a fin de que ya no servamos al pecado, pues el que ha muerto queda libre del pecado. Por lo tanto, si hemos muerto con Cristo, estamos seguros de que también viviremos con Él, pues sabemos que Cristo, una vez resucitado entre los muertos, ya nunca morirá. La muerte ya no tiene dominio sobre Él, porque al morir, murió el pecado de una vez para siempre, y al resucitar, vive ahora para Dios. Lo mismo ustedes, considérense muertos al pecado y vivos para Dios en Cristo Jesús, Señor nuestro. Palabra de Dios.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
hand is exalted. I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord. Alleluia. Become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. Very early, when the sun had risen on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb. They were saying to one another, "Who will roll back the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone had been rolled back. It was very large. On entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, clothed in a white robe, and they were utterly amazed. He said to them, "Do not be amazed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, the crucified. He has been raised. He's not here. Behold the place where they laid him. But go and tell his disciples and Peter, he's going before you to Galilee. There you will see him as he told you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Happy Easter. I have one word for us as we celebrate Easter, and that is let me see if I can get this right. Can anybody finish that for me? V as in Victor. Love. I don't know what's going on with me or what God is doing with me, but that is what I have been experiencing. Let me just say, since last Sunday, what did we celebrate last Sunday? Palm Sunday. And our church, all our masses, Saturday 5 p.m., Sunday 7:15, 8:45, 10:30, and the 12:30. We were so blessed to see all the children of God coming to pray. The families were here. Little ones were here praying with us. And I felt the love of God. I not only felt the love of God, but I was also able to smell it. Smell the love of God. Have you tried that? Please do. It's a good one, and it's for free. Smell the love of God. all around us. And then, on Friday, that was yesterday, we had the Passion of the Lord. We had so many children of God who came to pray, to venerate the cross. And I was sitting over there and just praying because I was watching people coming to venerate the cross with faith, with appreciation, with love. There were moments that were even more special because I saw parents coming with their little ones and showing them that this cross is special. I was touched. I was smelling love as I saw everyone coming to venerate the cross. Love is real. You can feel it. You can smell it. You can receive it. And you can share it. This morning at 10 o'clock, we have our Easter basket blessing. I could be wrong, but I think this morning we had at least 200 Easter basket blessing all here. 200 Easter basket to be blessed. I was able to feel, to sense, to taste, and to smell the love of God. And right now, look what's happening. You're still here. Are you guys okay? You are still here. Thank you. But let me go to my left. We are so blessed to have this amazing group of people who are able to sing for us and with us in three languages, Latin, Spanish, and English. That is love. That is love. Can you feel it? Can you smell it? I hope you are. If not, we're gonna bless holy water in a moment and I'll come by you and bless you with extra water. Love, my brothers and sisters. So maybe just a very simple way of concluding here my brief homily. I normally preach for like 45 minutes. Not really. But again, my brothers and sisters, how are you experiencing love? How are you allowing love to embrace you? How are you allowing love to lift you up? How are you allowing love to share your blessings, your goodness, and your strength with others? Love. You can feel it. You can smell it. You can receive it. And you can share it. And it's for free. That is God, who is love. Feliz Pascua. ¿Alguien habla español aquí? ¡Feliz Pascua! Oh, that's much better. Un poco mejor. Gracias. ¡Feliz Pascua! Tengo una sola palabra para nosotros en mi homilía el día de hoy, y es el amor. Amor. Y creo que ya me entendieron todos, ¿verdad? Nomás voy a repetirlo un poquito. O solamente preguntarnos, hacernos la pregunta: ¿cómo estamos experimentando el amor hoy? Que estamos aquí celebrando la resurrección de nuestro Señor Jesús. ¿Cómo estamos dejando al amor a que nos haga sentir bien, nos haga sentir pleno, nos haga sentir con energía? ¿Cómo estamos permitiendo al amor que nos ayude a ser buenos con los demás? ¿Cómo nos está ayudando el amor para compartir nuestros dones y talentos con los demás? ¿Cómo está el amor ayudándonos a ser instrumentos de la buena nueva, de la buena noticia? Creo que algo raro me está pasando a mí, pero todos los días estar aquí en San Cleto es un día muy especial. Es un día hermoso, porque puedo sentir, hasta puedo oler el amor haciéndose presente aquí entre nosotros. Y ese amor viene de Dios. Y ese amor viene del corazón de Cristo. Y ese amor nos invita a seguir creyendo en Dios, en Jesús, en el Espíritu Santo, en su iglesia, en nuestra comunidad. Entonces les invito, mientras celebramos la Pascua, la resurrección de Jesús, le invito, déjese abrazar por ese amor. Ábrale la puerta de tu corazón a ese amor. Y deja que el amor haga grandes cosas en ti y a través de ti para los demás. Amén. And now we will move to the third part of our Easter Vigil, which is the baptismal liturgy. If you could please stand. Tonight, we have Christina and Eliana receiving the sacrament of baptism. Dearly beloved, with one heart and one soul, let us, by our prayers, come to the aid of these our brothers and sisters in their blessed hope, so that as they approach the fount of rebirth, the Almighty Father may bestow on them all his merciful help.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ,
Mother of God, pray for us. Saint Michael,
pray for us.
Saint Cletus,
pray for us.
Saint Peter,
pray for us.
Saint Paul, Saint Andrew,
pray for us.
Saint James,
pray for us.
Saint John,
pray for us.
Saint Thomas,
pray for us.
Saint Philip, Saint Bartholomew,
pray for us.
Saint Christina,
pray for us.
Saint Helena,
pray for us.
Saint Augustine,
pray for us.
Saint Cecilia, Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Christ graciously hear us.
Almighty, ever-living God, be present by the mysteries of your great love, and send forth the spirit of adoption to create the new peoples brought to birth for you in the font of baptism, so that what is to be carried out by our humble service may be brought to fulfillment by your mighty power through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'm going to ask you to stand there, and I'm going to come over here with our deacon and the Easter candle, and here is the water, and I'm going to say a prayer. If you could join me in silence, this is a very beautiful prayer which we're going to use to bless this water so that two of our sisters will join our Catholic Church once again through the sacrament of baptism. And this is love. O God, who by invisible power accomplish a wondrous effect through sacramental signs, and who in many ways have prepared water, your creation, to show forth the grace of baptism. O God, whose Spirit in the first moment of the world's creation hovered over the waters, so that the very substance of water would even then take to itself the power to sanctify. O God, who by the outpouring of the flood foreshadowed regeneration, so that from the mystery of one and the same element of water would come an end to vice and a beginning of virtue. O God, who caused the children of Abraham to pass dry shod through the Red Sea, so that the chosen people set free from slavery to Pharaoh would prefigure the people of the baptized. O God, whose Son, baptized by John in the waters of the Jordan, was anointed with the Holy Spirit, and as he hung upon the cross, gave forth water from his side along with blood, and after his resurrection, commanded his disciples, "Go forth, teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Look now, we pray, upon the face of your church, and graciously unseal for her the fountain of baptism, May this water receive by the Holy Spirit the grace of your only begotten Son, so that the human nature created in your image and washed clean through the sacrament of baptism from all the squalor of the life of old may be found worthy to rise to the life of newborn children through water and the Holy Spirit. May the power of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, we pray, come down through your Son into the fullness of this fount, so that all who have been buried with Christ by baptism into death may rise again to life with him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Now comes the profession of faith, renunciation of sin, and your response will be, I do, and we can join them as well. Do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children?
I do.
Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin?
I do.
Do you reject Satan, father of sin and prince of darkness?
I do.
And now comes the profession of faith. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
Now comes the baptism. So I'm going to ask to come one by one, with your family or a sponsor, come forward to the baptismal font. Christina, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. A towel. Eliana, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. After they have been Christina, Eliana baptized with the holy water, now comes anointing after baptism. I'm going to ask you to come over here. And we have a special prayer. The God of power and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ has freed you from sin and brought you to new life through water and the Holy Spirit. He now anoints you with the chrism of salvation, so that united with his people, you may remain forever a member of Christ, who is priest, prophet, and king. Now comes clothing with a baptismal garment. Christina and Eliana, you have become a new creation and have clothed yourselves in Christ. Receive this baptismal garment and bring it unstained to the judgment seat of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that you may have everlasting life. Amen. And now comes the presentation of a lighted candle. I'm going to ask the godparent, and they will light the candle from the Easter candle. Christina and Eliana, if you can raise your candle. You have been enlightened by Christ. Walk always as children of the light, and keep the flame of faith alive in your heart. When the Lord comes, may you go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. Amen. And now we continue with our Easter vigil, and I'll invite you to light your candles from the Easter candle. We will do the renewal of baptismal promises. Vamos ahora a hacer la renovación de las promesas bautismales. Maybe Eliana and Christina can share the lights with others as well. And Deacon Franco will be coming by you with a Easter candle as well. Christina and Eliana, thank you very much for sharing your light with all of us. My dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so, now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children? I do. ¿Renuncian ustedes a las seducciones de la iniquidad para que no los domine el pecado? Sí, renuncio. Do you reject Satan, father of sin and prince of darkness? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? ¿Crees en Jesucristo, su único Hijo, nuestro Señor, que nació de Santa María, la Virgen, fue crucificado, muerto y sepultado, resucitó de entre los muertos y está sentado a la derecha del Padre? Sí, creo. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestow on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus, our Lord, for eternal life. Amen. Amen. Now comes the sprinkling rite.
Waters waters of life, creating life, baptized in faith, sealed with your love, waters of life, Spirit of God, called as your own, light for our lives, cleansed from all sin, baptized you are reborn, clothed in Christ, anointed priest and prophet king, welcomed in love, family of faith, joined as one, we share God's everlasting life. Waters of life, creating life, baptized in faith, your love, waters of life, Spirit of God, called as your
And four members of our community will be receiving the sacrament of confirmation. So that's Rob, Christina, Audrey, and Eliana. So after I say a prayer, you will be coming forward one by one with your sponsor. My dear candidates for confirmation, by your baptism, you have been born again in Christ, and you have become member of Christ and of his priestly people. Now you are to share in the outpouring of the Holy Spirit among us, the Spirit sent by the Lord upon his apostles at Pentecost and given by them and their successors to the baptized. The promised strength of the Holy Spirit, which you are to receive, will make you more like Christ and help you to be witnesses to his suffering, death, and resurrection. It will strengthen you to be active members of the church and to build up the body of Christ in faith and love. Moment of silence. I ask those who are going to receive the sacrament of confirmation if you could bow down. Laying on of hand. All-powerful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit, you freed your sons and daughters from sin and gave them new life. Send your Holy Spirit upon them to be their helper and guide. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of right judgment and courage, the spirit of knowledge and reverence. Fill them with a spirit of wonder and awe in your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Now comes the anointing with the Holy Chrism. be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Sita, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you. Cecilia, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. Jonathan, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Thank you. And now we continue with our Mass as usual. Universal Prayer, Oración de los Fieles. My brothers and sisters, in the joy of this holy night, let us raise our prayers to God the Most High. Hermanos, en el gozo de esta noche, elevemos nuestras oraciones al Dios Altísimo.
That the church, washed in the saving waters of baptism, will be born anew in Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the earth, wounded and broken, will be regenerated and restored, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the war in Ukraine will be ended through Christ's victorious light, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Que aquellos que han sido iniciados en la comunidad de creyentes crezcan más profundamente en la mente y el corazón de Cristo resucitado. Roguemos al Señor.
Señor, escúchanos.
Que a los enfermos se les muestre la luz de sanación de Cristo. Roguemos al Señor.
Señor, escúchanos.
Que los que han muerto volverán a la vida con Cristo Jesús en el cielo y por los feligreses de San Cleto, a quienes recordamos especialmente en esta Eucaristía, roguemos al Señor.
Señor, escúchanos.
Redeeming God, you have raised your Son from the darkness of the tomb and made all creation new. Hear these prayers and help us to live as children of the light. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Please extinguish your candles. Por favor, apaguen sus veladoras.
For our brothers and sisters viewing this evening's Mass at home, please remember St. Cletus Parish with your financial support by mailing in your contribution, donating through our website, or scanning the QR code on your screen. Thank you again for your generosity.
pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Accept the sacrifice at your hand. Praise is in the glory of his name, for our good and with all our Holy Church.
Accept, we ask, O Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what was begun in the Paschal Mysteries may, by the working of your power, bring us to the healing of eternity through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this night above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with this paschal joy, every land, every people exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Santo eres en verdad, Padre, y con razón te alaban todas tus criaturas, ya que por Jesucristo, tu Hijo, Señor nuestro, con la fuerza del Espíritu Santo das vida y santificas todo, y congregas a tu pueblo sin cesar, para que ofrezca en tu honor un sacrificio sin mancha, de donde sale el sol hasta el ocaso. Por eso, Padre, te suplicamos que santifiques por el mismo Espíritu estos dones que hemos separado para ti, de manera que se conviertan en el cuerpo y la sangre de Jesucristo, Hijo tuyo y Señor nuestro, que nos mandó celebrar estos misterios. Porque él mismo, la noche en que iba a ser entregado, tomó pan, y dando gracias te bendijo, lo partió y lo dio a sus discípulos, diciendo: tomen y coman todos de él, porque esto es mi cuerpo, que será entregado por ustedes. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. the mystery of faith. Así pues, Padre, al celebrar ahora el memorial de la pasión salvadora de tu Hijo, de su admirable resurrección y ascensión al cielo, mientras esperamos su venida gloriosa, te ofrecemos en esta acción de gracias el sacrificio vivo y santo. Dirige tu mirada sobre la ofrenda de tu Iglesia y reconoce en ella la víctima por cuya inmolación quisiste devolvernos tu amistad para que, fortalecido con el cuerpo y la sangre de tu Hijo y lleno de su Espíritu Santo, formemos en Cristo un solo cuerpo y un solo espíritu.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Cletus, and all the saints whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for our faith in God. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation be prayed, O Lord, and may it be peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
A nuestros hermanos difuntos y a cuantos murieron en tu amistad, recíbelos en tu reino, donde esperamos gozar todos juntos de la plenitud eterna de tu gloria. Por Cristo Señor nuestro, por quien concedes al mundo todos los bienes. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Líbranos de todos los males, Señor, y concédenos la paz en nuestros días, para que, ayudados por tu misericordia, vivamos siempre libres de pecado y protegidos de toda perturbación, mientras esperamos la gloriosa venida de nuestro Salvador Jesucristo.
Reino tuyo.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace. La paz de Cristo. Y sobre ti.
Este es el Cordero de Dios que quita el pecado del mundo. Dichosos los invitados a la cena del Señor.
Thank you.
Let us pray.
Oremos. Infúndenos, Señor, tu espíritu de caridad, para que vivamos siempre unidos en tu amor, los que hemos participado de este sacramento de la muerte y resurrección de Jesucristo.
Pour out on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those you have nourished by this Paschal sacrament one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I feel like I don't want to go anywhere else tonight. Still want to pray a little bit more. What do you think? Okay. Wow. Thank you. Thank you. I really enjoyed it, praying with you and especially baptizing our sisters and today. Let's give them a big round of applause. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Congratulations. And for those who received the sacrament of confirmation as well, let's give them a thank you. Thank you. And there will be a special reception immediately after the final blessing in our parish center, so everyone is invited. My special appreciation and gratitude to everyone who helped for this evening, for the Easter Vigil, our sacristans, gushers, lecturers, Eucharistic ministers, altar servers, Deacon Franco, Father Michael, and our wonderful and amazing and very generous choir. Let's give them a big thank you. Thank you. Happy Easter. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I think we don't have more announcements, so that's a good thing. And the Lord be with you.
Bow your heads, pray for God's blessing, and respond amen to each invocation.
May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion, defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
Que les conceda el premio de la inmortalidad aquel que los ha redimido para la vida eterna con la resurrección de su unigénito.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God,
the Father,
and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen. The message ascended, go in peace, alleluia. Hallelujah.